Hey guys, it is Miss Sim Reno. If you are returning to the channel, welcome back. And if you're brand new, I am very excited that you decided to join me here today for another speed build. And today we are finally using the Courtyard Oasis kit in a full build that is heavily inspired by Moroccan architecture. So what I wanted to do, and I kind of explained this in my last video, which was a traveler's apartment, where that was my first time using some of the items from this kit that was released on the 18th, but I wanted to do a little bit of research before I did a giant build, like more so a family home or something like that. Before I jumped into something like that, I wanted to do more research because I know nothing of Moroccan architecture or culture whatsoever, and I was like, well, this is a great learning opportunity for me because I really want to get this right. So we all know at this point that center courtyards are basically one of the staples of Moroccan homes, or like more so traditional Moroccan homes from what I was researching. And these are called, if I pronounce this wrong, please just tell me in the comments because now I've heard like three or four different pronunciations and it kind of drives me crazy, but I've heard them called riads. I am not sure which one is correct, but riads, that's what I'm going to go with. No, maybe I should go with riads. I don't know. Riads are traditional homes and palaces in Morocco. So this home here, this is a family home. That's what I'm calling it. However, let me just say this is huge. And the only reason it's so big is because we know that proportions in The Sims can be a little bit off sometimes. And to be able to make this center courtyard span the first story and the second story, and for me to be able to kind of work out a floor plan where I could actually make it for a larger family and not have it just be, I mean, it is a huge box. It's a huge square with a bunch of little rectangles off of it. But I was trying not to make just a single story house. I wanted it to have a lot of volume to it. I wanted it to be really, really grand. That's what I was going for. So anyway, so proportions in The Sims, we all know that they're a little bit off, and therefore to make this center courtyard and have all of the rooms just be of a decent size to actually fit the grandeur of the entire build, I had to make this build huge. Like, it is giant. And you can see me doing the floor plan prior to doing pretty much anything else. And that's just because I had to make sure that I had room for everything. Like, I really didn't know if I was going to be able to have room for everything in this build, but this took me about maybe like 8 to 10 hours to build, I want to say. And you can even see across the street on one of the other lots was one of my first concepts of this build. It took me a really long time, but I am so, so proud with the end result. So you can see here, I'm actually using platforms as well. I use platforms to kind of make a little bit more of a dynamic roof, because I was noticing that a lot of the roofs of these riads in Morocco are not flat. They are not flat whatsoever. You don't see your typical gabled roof that often, at least not from what I was researching and seeing. So I decided to use platforms to make it a bit more dynamic. And it also gave me the opportunity to use the platform foundation that we got with this kit, which I was so thrilled to actually see. I completely forget about platforms sometimes because I don't use them that often. And therefore, the fact that they gave us a foundation for platforms, so thoughtful. Thank you, Sims team. Appreciate you. But you can see here that the build itself is pretty much coming together. Like, the shape of the build is here. And it's a little bit awkward because that courtyard is technically centered in the center of the build, but it's not centered on the roof, so it's a little bit weird. We just kind of ignore the roof. I actually think from certain angles it looks spectacular, so that's pretty much why I kept it. But these windows and columns and the arches are stunning. Like, I can't get over how beautiful these objects actually are. And in my research too, I was kind of realizing that there are different kinds of arches. There's different intricacies depending on what the structure is. So there are usually a lot of geometric patterns as well in Moroccan architecture and design. So when we're looking at the tiles, they are very geometric, and there are patterns in like the wood carvings and the doors that we got with this pack, as well as like the coffee table and things. It's just the attention to detail was amazing. And I do apologize if I sound like I kind of don't know what I'm talking about, because this is all very, very new to me. So I am still excited to learn so, so much more. But another thing that I learned is that for estates, well, I don't want to call them estates, but for more so traditional Moroccan homes, there is They were built for privacy in mind, is basically what I was gathering. So there were either these, I don't know if you can call them fences, they're probably more so walls, but there were walls that kind of surround the property as well to really just keep eyes off, right? And then there actually weren't a lot of windows on the exterior of homes because all of them were really pointing and focusing towards that center courtyard. But for the sake of the Sims, I did make some creative liberties here and put some windows on the exterior. And there are some around basically the entire build just because I felt as though that center courtyard, especially in the Sims, is not going to bring in enough light to really light the whole house. So I definitely have windows on this, but I thought that that was a really interesting thing to learn. And you can see here that we jumped full speed ahead, there is a pool surrounding this entire home, and I used platforms and put some grass flooring to actually create some landscaping around the build. I basically made this like a floating island home, and that was not my intention originally, but I think it came out so nice. And the first thing that we actually do is work on the front entryway. And I mentioned this in my traveler's apartment as well, that it seems as though a lot of the jungle adventure items that we have in game already really mesh well with this pack. And I want to emphasize that these are two different parts of the world completely, right? So Jungle Adventure is, I think, more so representative of like South American cultures and stuff like that. And I know that, of course, this pack is more so supposed to be highlighting Morocco, which is in Northern Africa. So totally different, but they go really, really well together. And I don't know if it's the intricacies of the details, if it's the use of color and stuff like that, but I thought it went together really nicely. And I used a ton of base game, which also blew my mind. I didn't think that the base game curtains and even some artwork was going to work really well for this build, so I was really shocked in finding that out and kind of playing around with some things. But in this entryway, there is a little console table here with that mirror from Jungle Adventure, which is so beautiful that I don't use often enough. And then there are, of course, some plants, there's a bookcase, and then there's a small seating area. Now, this entryway was so awkward to me, and I didn't really know how to divvy it up, so I did put the bubble blowing machine over here in this little tiny nook, just because I thought it was a nice way to actually utilize the space. And I'm also thrilled because the overhanging lights that I used throughout this entire build, you would think they were from this kit. They are not. They are from Journey to Batuu. And I keep saying this in so many voiceovers at this point, I'm just shocked as to how much I am actually using Journey to Batuu on a daily basis. Like when I'm building, it actually shows up all the time. And that really confuses me. But here I was thinking of adding an aquarium, but I thought it just was a little bit too modern for this build. Really wasn't working for me. So I end up putting a chess table here, and I use these chairs from the Hispanic Heritage update that we got to base game, I think a couple of months ago. And I just thought I went with a new, more like neutral tone, a more neutral swatch for those chairs because there's already so much color in this build. But I don't know, I liked it because it added another activity, because in this build as well, there is a, I'm going to call it like the formal living room, which is technically the courtyard. But within that courtyard, there's not a TV. I had to make like a smaller informal living room with a TV. I don't know, I just felt like I was lacking on activities for your Sims to actually take part in, so I wanted to make sure that I added the chess table. And here is going to be the dining room, and it opens up to the backyard as well as the center courtyard. So that's basically one of the staples, is the courtyard is literally in the center, and there's archways or even doors or some kind of like, I'm not gonna call it like a patio, but there's almost like this circulating hallway where all the doors are off of. So there's access to the center courtyard from basically every room on the first floor, which I think is so freaking cool. I love it so much. I'm shocked as to how much I like this house. And I'm gonna say that because I used the tallest wall height for the first floor to be able to use some of these arches and doors, mainly the front door, actually. I had to use the tallest wall height, and I was actually really upset about that at first because I never use the tall wall height. I avoid the apartments in Samishuno with the tallest wall height. I despise it. I feel like I have to fill every aspect of it, like every part of the wall, and I can't. But I think for this, with this pack, especially because the doors and arches and the windows, actually, even though they are for those bigger windows are for the medium wall height and the smaller ones are for the smallest wall height, or I mean really any wall height that it fits, but basically what I'm trying to say is that the windows and arches actually really take up a lot of space in a good way, because I think that they fill and utilize that tall wall height to the to the best of their ability, as if they have a choice or if they're doing this on purpose. But I just think that they really, really work. But here we are in the kitchen, and I use these base game counters as well as the Country Kitchen Kit appliances to actually bring a little bit of vibrancy and a little bit more of, I don't know, maybe like an older style with the appliances, because in my traveler's apartment, I use the Jungle Adventure appliances, which would obviously work here as well. But I thought the Country Kitchen Kit ones were kind of nice. They had a little bit more curvature to them, which I thought was really appealing in looking at the archways and everything that we have with this kit. So I thought it worked out really, really nicely. And there's actually a breakfast table as well. So there is that big formal dining room, which is just my favorite room, I think, almost in the entire house. Like, I literally love that room so much. It was the first one that I even thought of when I was building this. But yeah, I'm really glad that there's a breakfast table, and there's also this little tiny island bar as well. So there are plenty of places for your Sims to sit and eat. And I didn't even mention, this is for a family of, what do I have? I have two parents. So there's two parents, a kid's room. There is a teen room, a toddler room with two toddlers. So it's for a family of six. And then there is an additional room that has an archway upstairs that is kind of like a family game room that leads out to the one and only balcony in this build. You could technically turn it into another bedroom if you really needed the space, but I thought that the access to the balcony should be restricted for older Sims. Like teen and up, you probably wouldn't want your kid or your toddlers to have access to a balcony. So that's why I ended up just making it like an arched family game room type thing. But the kitchen is pretty much coming together at this point. I did use a few different like plants and things. I also added some floating shelves in the corner. It looked a little bit busy, I have to admit, at least in this corner space. And that's mainly because of the coffee maker, but I just didn't think that it looked great anywhere else. And I kind of just really wanted to add some floating shelves, but I didn't want them to go all the way to the ceiling, because that's probably what I would end up doing. Therefore, I decided that the corner was the best spot. Also, I'm sorry if you're hearing me like swallow. We're doing an early morning voiceover, and I have my coffee here with me, and I'm not quite energized yet, but I'm just waking up. So I've got a lot going on. I haven't talked much this morning. Okay. That's what I'm trying to say. I haven't talked much this morning. So we're getting there. But I also added these candles from City Living pretty much all over the build as well. You guys will probably see me utilize a lot of the same objects, at least for lighting and curtains and things like that, just because, well, one, it's consistent, but two, I just feel as though they matched the absolute best for this build. So hopefully you guys don't mind, but the kitchen is pretty much done at this point, and then we move on to the center courtyard, which these plants, these standing plants, I love them so, so much. I talked about them in my other apartment renovation where I actually first used this kit. And I think they're beautiful. They're huge. They're banana trees, I want to say, banana leaf trees. And they're absolutely stunning. Like, they're giant though. So when you size them down, when you're indoors, they cast a huge, huge shadow, which is kind of unfortunate. This is definitely not me knocking it. I think they're amazing. So I wanted to make sure that I used them, and I put them in the center courtyard, but I did want to use them throughout the home as well. But sizing them down just did not work. Like, it worked, it literally did size them down, but it didn't work because of the shadow casting. I also used the rug from the Paranormal Stuff pack a lot. I thought it fit in really nicely and brought even more color into this build. And the courtyard is very simple. It's really just a seating area, but off camera I think I add like a stereo to the floor just so there's some music out there maybe. And then this is that really informal, tiny, squished in extra living space where I added the TV, because let's just be honest, in The Sims, you pretty much need a TV or some other items to help with skill building, to build the fun skill up, or not fun skill, but to get Sims a fun up and things like that. So I had to make sure that I added a TV. And then this is going to be basically the, I guess we can call it a hallway, the landing area. This is where the staircase is that leads up to the second floor, and I just put some artwork, another little seating area with some of those armchairs, as well as another console table and more plants. There's a lot of plants in this build. I say a lot, I put a lot of plants in my builds to begin with, but I think that in this build in particular, it was a necessity, if that makes sense. I also use these lanterns from the new kit, which are absolutely gorgeous. They are wall hanging lanterns compared to the ones from Journey to Batuu that hang from the ceiling. And I also used these vases, since people like the way that I say vase all the time like that, because it's literally like when I see the word vase, that is how I say it in my head. So I say it out loud like that, which kind of just makes me laugh too. If you can't laugh at yourself, then what are you doing, you know? But I do use a few of those vases around as well from Jungle Adventure. There's also a vase that came with this kit and I do use it. I think I used it in the front entryway, but I might use it a few more times as well. And then this is going to be just a little kind of study area, little office area. What I'm really appreciating about this house is that everything is pretty much connected. It's like each room is connected to one another. Aside from the bedrooms and stuff upstairs, but each room is pretty much connected to one another. So this office space is pretty much open for the whole family to use, which I just really like. And that paranormal desk came in clutch. Like, I was so excited about it. I just thought it worked perfectly. And everything is pretty simply decorated in the sense that I didn't overclutter a lot of things. And that's mainly just because there's so much personality and energy in the intricate details of all of these items for this kit. Like, I feel as though they are not only functional, but they're ornamental too. Like, they're just so, so pretty that I don't have to overclutter a lot of things. Does that make sense? It feels balanced. I don't know if that kind of like rings true for you guys as well. But here we are decorating that landing space. I do add a few plants up here. You'll kind of notice in the screenshots, things do shift around just a little bit just so I can make that room through that door work, because that's a bathroom. There are, well, one, two, I have to count again. So the master bedroom, there's the kids room, teen room, and the toddler room. So there's four bedrooms, and I believe there's also four bathrooms. So there's a bathroom downstairs. I didn't film any of the bathrooms because this build took so long, but there is a full bathroom downstairs. All of them are full baths, and then there's three full bathrooms upstairs as well. I think one of them actually is even off of the game room that I end up giving them, which is kind of nice. I could have made this one over here an ensuite bathroom, but I just didn't want to keep adding more and more doors and entrances to bathrooms and rooms because I felt a little restricted to begin with. But this is the master bedroom, which I really, really enjoyed. I loved using this bed, which I believe, is this a city living bed? No. Is it? I can never tell. I can never remember. I don't remember if it's City Living or if it was from a free update in base game at one point. I cannot recall, but it's beautiful and I thought it fit perfectly here. They also just have a dresser, another mirror, an armchair, and I added this fireplace from Jungle Adventure in the master bedroom as well as the kids' room on the opposite wall. I don't know why I wanted to put a fireplace in a kids' room. However, it looked really nice and it was really pretty. You probably wouldn't trust a child with having a fireplace in their room, but I just liked it. I wasn't able to put one downstairs anywhere, at least not anywhere that I thought would really fit, if that makes sense. So putting it up in the bedroom, especially a master bedroom, I thought was really kind of luxurious. I thought it'd be really, really nice. And this ends up being the kids' room. And this could be for, of course, a child sim who is a male or female. It does not matter whatsoever. And there's their little handy fireplace, but it has a very like strong blue and orange theme. Again, what's really beautiful about this pack and all of the colors that come with it is I feel so much more comfortable mixing a ton of different things together. Like, we didn't get any furniture for bedrooms or anything in this style, but I thought as though I could still make a room with the objects that we have that would still work. And I thought it came out really, really cute. There's a creativity table in there, a wardrobe, there's a bookcase, there's a mirror on the wall, and then just a few different toys as well as nightlights. Nightlights are very important. I never forget nightlights for kids or toddlers. And this ends up being the teen's room. And I think that this teen is just very into music. And I was, oh, that was another thing. I was kind of researching like Moroccan music as well, because I love music. Like, music is unique everywhere, and I love it so much. So I was really enjoying kind of learning a little bit more about Moroccan music, and I was like, well, at least someone in this build has to play guitar. It's just a must. So I thought it might be the teen. And this teen also has a TV in their room and a video game console, because I just think that they're into all that stuff. I don't know, it seems like stereotypical teen stuff to me. But there's also a dresser and then this little love seat, which I thought was nice. And it's a pretty tiny room. It's a little bit, I don't know if, is it thin? It's a little bit small, and the toddler room is even smaller, but that's really just the proportion challenges, because if I wanted a hallway that wrapped around the center courtyard area, with access to all the different rooms, it was turned into a very wide build in The Sims. So the rooms can be a little bit skinny. I'm just kind of glad that I was able to make so many rooms and get so many Sims in this build. But yeah, I don't know. It was uncomfortable in that sense. But this ends up being the toddler room, and I really, really like it. Even though it's small and there really isn't too much in here, I thought it worked out very, very nicely because I used the paranormal curtains because I thought that they matched really well with this bed from Jungle Adventure yet again. And they have a little table in the center here with just a lamp. There's also an armchair. I think there's like a little ottoman near this window as well, that bigger window, and the little like cubby storage thing for their clothes and stuff. So at least they have a quote unquote wardrobe. And then there's just artwork and whatnot. But since this wall was so long, I added this mural again from the Free Heritage or Hispanic Heritage update, my apologies, from a few months ago, just because I thought it was so lively and pretty, and I just absolutely loved it. So there isn't too much going on in the toddler's room, but I still think it came out pretty cute. I hope you guys agree. And then this is one of the bathrooms, so you kind of got a little peek at the bathrooms, because once I added the toddler room, I had to actually add toddler potties all over the place because I hadn't had them in any of the bathrooms yet. And then the final room that we work on here is the little game room. So I get rid of the door, I add an archway, I add the Don't Wake the Llama table and a little seating area. And on that balcony, there's also a painting easel and another seating area, because I just feel like you'd want to relax in this entire home. Like wherever you are, you would want to relax. That's how I feel. They also have the, what is that? Is that billiards? That's not billiards. What is that? Darts. Darts. Oh my gosh. They have the dartboard. Completely forgot what that was called. And then I just decorate a few more things on the console table. And then the backyard also is basically a giant pool. And then they just have another seating area with the new fountain we got with this kit. But I hope you guys did enjoy this build. This was a passion project. It's probably my favorite one to date. So let me know what you think, and I will catch you next time I post a video, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.